core fiber of your being, and
you want
don't touch me.
You can have the rest of them.
You have mints?
They're sour.
Sour?
You can keep the rest of them.
What is this?
Sour, sugar-free strawberry mixed berry cherry.
They're the version of like Lifesavers something or other, except
but like
they're
mints.
From Aldi.
But they're exactly the same shit. They're different fruit flavors.
I'm gonna have two of them. Is that okay?
You can have all of them.
No, I just want two of them.
Okay.
And then you can have it back.
You're gonna
but covered now it's with got, germs now.
Yeah, now it's covered with germs.
What?
Still covered with germs.
No, I just took two of them.
Yeah, and the rest that you had your hands. I mean, you had your hands in there, right?
Did no, I just took two of them, and I didn't.
You didn't touch anything else.
I didn't touch anything else.
You're, are you like the master of operation?
Yes, I'm very good at operation.
Get this.
This
out
is
of my face. I don't want that. My face.
This
thing.
Is the quality stream. As a warning, and I know everyone's going to be very sad about this. I'm not going to be here all night because I have a bad head cold.
That's fine. That
I
is
just
fine.
Want to let you know that.
I think when you said you weren't going to be here all night, I thought you were going to show up later. I was ready to go without you for a bit.
Sure. Oh, these are good. Ooh. Ooh, they're sour though. Ooh, yep. I like them.
They have them at Aldi. They're like a dollar or something.
Mm. So what is this game?
There's a couple different versions of them too. The citrus ones are even better.
What the hell is this game?
This is Little Inferno.
Who the hell are you?
I'm Karen. I'm Rich's fiance. I'm back up in Wisconsin for a limited engagement. Our engagement isn't limited, but sooner or later it'll end because we'll be married.
Usually engagements are limited.
Yes,
by
yes.
The way.
But I mean, I'm up temporarily in Wisconsin.
Get your shit together.
I know. I'm working on it.
All right, that's fine. All right,
in every sense of the word. But this is Little Inferno, and mostly you just set things on fire, and it's funny.
Yay!
You set
fire.
School buses on fire. You set opera singers on fire. You set nuclear weapons on fire in different combinations, and you try to get the right combinations so you can unlock more parts of the catalog, so you can set even more stuff on fire.
Why don't you show us?
Okay.
Okay. These things are sour. I love them. I love your sour mints. Do you guys like Sour Patch Kids?
Yeah, I just finished a bag of Trolley gummy worms.
Oh, those are good, too.
I'm big on sour.
Yeah, you know,
every once in a while. Every once in a while, you need a sour thing.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
You can't really overdo it too much, though, because then your mouth starts to hurt.
Exactly. You know, vary it up.
Like every 15 years, maybe?
Oh.
It's starting to win.
Okay. I'll bring Fuckbot back, but hopefully everyone is noticing our new emoticon.
Touch and hold anywhere to make a fire.
We got
fire.
A new emoticon. It's Science Mike.
Fire.
Whoop.
So you just click on the screen, and then fire starts.
Right. And then it burns. Burn, baby, burn, and then money comes out. Everything right. Turns into money.
I wish I could burn things and turn them into money.
Yeah.
Unless it's less money than the thing was worth. Then
I guess technically you could do that.
Then it's a horrible superpower.
Although I'm not sure if this actually turns into Mike. But anyway.
Science
terms
Mike,
and conditions. Yep. Drag me.
Okay. So then the terms and conditions
more
explode.
Terms and conditions. Burn those too. Here's an envelope. Congratulations on the legitimate purchase of your new Little Inferno Entertainment Fireplace. We have lovingly crafted each fireplace to warm your home and your heart. Stay warm in there. Wee! Love, Miss Nancy from the Tomorrow Corporation. That's nice of you, Miss Nancy. Now, excuse me, I have things to burn.
Yay!
Oh, look, money!
Burn!
Those are C's for coin or horseshoes? Probably C for coin, yeah.
Is this like Jerry's game?
I have no idea.
It's a thing from Rick and Morty where it's like a Android type game, you know, and it's just balloons on the screen and you just click the balloons to pop them and that's all there is to the game.
Well, you burn stuff, but you gotta find the right combinations of things to burn together.
Show me how this works.
Well, we haven't gotten there yet.
We haven't gotten there yet. Okay.
We haven't even gotten our first catalog.
We're in
yet.
Tutorial. All right, tutorial mode.
Have
tutorial
you already
mode
burned
engaged.
All your things? That's okay. You can always buy more with your brand new catalog.
Oh, I'm
love
upset that it's not a cat.
Miss Nancy.
Catalog.
Yeah, here's the first catalog.
I was expecting
catalog
to burn a cat.
So, we open our catalog, and right
I
now
like
we
burning
only have three things open. We have the Little Inferno collector poster, framed edition poster, may lose value when burned.
Yeah.
Corn in the cob, made with all-natural high-fructose corn syrup, also doubles as car fuel.
Ooh, and we can make popcorn. Hey. I like that.
And Letterbox, optional profanity blocker accessory for easier parenting.
Yay! Profanity.
I bet car fuel is expensive.
So, we'll buy one of those.
Get some corn. I want some popped corn.
5 points. My order has shipped. Oh, yeah. And we'll take
this looks like it was made by the guys who made World of Goo.
And
did you guys ever play World of Goo?
What is
World of Goo is great.
World of Goo is just it's like a little gooey platformer puzzle.
He's like made out of tar and he kind of marginally sticks to the ceiling.
Wait, is that like Glitch or Gitch?
Oh, you know, I think I'm thinking of Gish.
Gish! That's one we should play too.
World of Goo is Gish-esque.
Alarm clock. It was all a dream. Somebody else's credit card. Yay. Let's go shopping. So how do I get out of here again? Let's X.
We're playing this in Steam right now. You have this on your pad.
I have this on my
your Padmotron. Is that what that's called?
Yes, I have it on an Android-based tablet.
An Andromic Padmotron. Yeah.
So, we'll pop that in there.
An electronic Padmotron.
And we'll pop that in there.
That's great.
And let's see, some letters. Yeah. And different things take like these are all open real quick, but. Some of the things, you can also burn spiders.
You should burn the spiders. Burn all the spiders.
And fire tends to spread from thing to thing. Like, see, this is on fire, and now this will catch fire next to it.
Are you a pyromaniac? Are
you a little pyromaniac? And look, all this different stuff does different stuff. Like, this just turns into popcorn.
Yay! Oh, you got
and
a
more
thing.
Money. Yeah, that's like a dollar instead of a coin or something.
I'm going to be honest. I don't get it.
And look, fire.
You just burn things.
Yeah, but what's the...
Well, you see, you try to make different combinations. Like, someone else's combo is going to have to do with somebody else's credit card. Bike pirate combo probably has to do with a bike and a pirate. But they get to be more complicated.
Oh.
So you try to do these different combos.
Okay. I'm with you.
But you don't necessarily know what the combos are. You know, the name gives you a clue.
You burn things.
So someone else's combo, it's going to have to do someone else's credit card. And then maybe one of these, maybe one of these. You have five slots. So we'll go with one of these.
Rich is giving me a look.
We'll go with a credit
card. I need some tissues. I'll be right back.
Credit card. Maybe an alarm clock. If this is boring to you, I mean,
no, it's fine. As long as we can talk, chit chat. Can you hand me your Android Matic pad thing? I want to get to the navigate to the chat so I can read it better for more.
You sure you don't want the Chromebook? Might be a little easier.
Whatever.
I would go with the Chromebook. It's probably easier. You're perfectly welcome to use my tablet too, though.
Will it be easier? Because I know the Chromebook, I'm gonna have to use this touchpad thing. We know how I feel about the touchpads.
Rich does not like touchpads.
Well, then find one of the mice down in one of the offices somewhere. Oh.
God, you see what I'm doing on this thing that is not a tablet? You see what I'm doing?
Oh, my God!
You see what I'm...
If that was the C720P model, it would have a touchscreen, but this one doesn't.
I'm sitting here like an old man. And I'm
trying to touch
or
my
a tiny
non-
child.
I'm touching the screen on Karen's laptop.
Okay.
That an old man or a tiny child. Bonga Doug!
So, you know.
Thank you for the tip. Bonga Doug would like to say, let's get the ball rolling.
Try
I don't know if that means tip ball rolling or burn ball. Is there a burn ball that we can burn?
There's all kinds of stuff you can burn. Burn, and more burn. Okay.
Let's burn.
So I tried burning a few things with a credit card. Ooh, I think we got it. All that money flying out. Or was that the credit card? Yeah, the credit card money shoots out of it.
Oh, that's funny.
The school bus is a lot of fun to burn. We haven't gotten the school bus yet. The little kids start screaming and the bus like crashes into the wall.
Yay! Murder.
Exactly. Let's see. Ooh, you're doing so great. But don't worry. Your little inferno is not like other games. There are no points. There is no score. You are not being timed. Just make a nice fire and stay warm in the glow of your high-definition entertainment product. But you can't do that forever. There is bound to be an end. Stay warm, Miss Nancy.
Now burn it.
It makes me warm and happy inside when you're excited about something.
This game is just it's wrong, but it's attractive.
You've got this smile on your face as you're just burning things. And really, it's charming. It's just charming.
Oh, pyromania.
Right. Well, that's the whole point of games in general, right? It's escapist fantasies that hopefully people don't do in real life. Hopefully people don't spend their real life burning everything around them.
Yeah, I have in fact never burned a school bus.
Right. And
in
so
real life.
And so you get that out of your system with this.
Yes.
And no, Chad, I have not seen Jessica Jones yet. I'm looking forward to it.
I have. I've seen the first episode.
Oh, yeah?
And so has Karen.
Having not...
Oh, my God!
Yes, I know. It's exciting, isn't it?
Having not read the Alias comics, which actually I just borrowed from him in hard copy, and I'm going to read them, but... Yeah, yeah. It was a little disorienting. Like, by the time you got through the entire episode, I could kind of figure out what was supposed to be going on, but you spent, like, 3/4 of the episode going, what the hell?
Okay. I'm okay with that. I have very high hopes, as I'm a big fan of the Daredevil. Oh, hold on. Just this guy, you know. Just seeing if this still works. Hi, Karen.
Hi, Jack.
Just this guy, you know.
Oh, wait. That's you can't somebody. Say that.
That's not Jack saying that.
That's
this is
just
somebody
this
in the
guy
chat.
You know.
Who said this? Who
just
said
this guy you know.
Just this guy you know.
Oh, okay. Hi, just this guy you know. Just this guy I don't know.
Just
but
this
I could
guy you
know.
Don't know.
But, it's possible I know him.
You've known him very well in the chat before, right? We know all of these people.
We know all these
They're
people.
Our close personal friends.
Well, for all I know, he could live next door to me.
It's anything's possible.
We could shop the same grocery store.
Oh, my God!
All right. For the record, Karen hates that audio clip of me saying, oh, my God.
I was being very nice. I didn't say anything.
Just a tip for everybody out there. She absolutely hates it.
Terrible. Terrible.
This is not my first time. This is actually the third time I've been on this chat, but most of the time I'm not here.
Third or fourth?
There was the one that you and I did without Jack.
Mm-hmm. And what we did with Jack.
With the
is that the same one we did with Bookworm?
yeah, I think the one that you and I did.
I
did
wasn't
some
there
regular
for
games, and then we did
Bookworm. For Bookworm.
I think we've done three.
Hold on.
Might
Lord,
be the fourth.
Lord Belmont with a tip wants to say, Jay should see Alan Wake in Deadliest Premonition. Notice that he says Jay should see Alan Wake and Deadliest Premonition, not play, because they are like Twin Peaks. The latter is very much so and very campy. Also, Jay, Rich, and Jack need to play the seventh guest together.
we're gonna have to.
Now we're gonna have to. Absolutely. And El Maton 106 says it's not like I wanted to tip you guys or anything. Gee. Well, thanks for the tip, El Maton.
This is your next door neighbor, and she's wants to be your. Pen pal sort of thing, and she is also has a little inferno fireplace like everybody, and
aww.
She also sets things on fire. And she sent you a photo of herself. Should we burn it?
Well, yes, of course. Burn everything. burn that too.
There are, in fact, like sort of Easter eggy things where certain things, if you manage to go to play the whole game without all of your slots, because some of them are being occupied by things that you only got in letters and that you decided not to burn.
Oh, sure, sure. I've heard really good things about Alan Wake.
We'll get the Sleeping Idol.
Ooh.
So anyway, back to what we're talking about before we get too far off topic.
Jessica Jones.
Yeah, what did you think of Jessica Jones as somebody who hadn't read the comic?
She already said that.
It was mildly disorienting, but, you know.
Positive, negative?
Mildly negative, but, you know, honestly.
But you did ask to read the comic.
I did ask to read the comic. I think the idea of the first episode was just kind of to lay the framework for everything. Mm-hmm. Which I'm not sure if it did in the best of all possible ways, but it was okay. I'm intrigued. I would like to see how further episodes go.
All right.
So you say it was laying the framework. To me, it just threw everything out there.
Well, yes.
The comic is all, you know, you don't hear anything about the Purple Man until, like, near the very end.
So you're saying
and
it was
and hey, spoilers. I know almost nothing about Alias or Jessica Jones.
Yeah, so all right, no, I'm not going to say anything.
No
then.
Spoilers whatsoever.
Yeah, likewise. I didn't know anything about Alias
then
or
I
Jessica
really
Jones.
Can't talk about it at all.
Don't talk. Well, yeah, I do plan on watching it.
I wasn't that. I didn't like hate Daredevil. The first episode. But, I'd rather read the comic.
Yeah.
I think Jessica Jones in the show is kind of a bitch.
She's kind of a bitch, and she's not quite so mean in the comic.
Okay.
Well, I thought she was just kind of just crazy.
Yeah.
She's just mental.
Relatively speaking to her comic book counterpart.
Uh-huh.
I thought she was a little bit mean.
Bricks can burn?
It should be able to.
Anything you put in there should be able to burn, right?
Well, I think actually about anything will burn if you get it hot enough. It's just that, you know, usually building bricks just don't get hot enough.
Well, I suppose. Oh.
Although I was watching a thing about siege warfare.
Hold on for a second, Karen. Hold on. John Kilo gave us a tip, hoping that I feel better soon. Thank you, John. I will try to feel better. Sorry. Go on, Karen.
Oh, I was just watching a thing about siege warfare where they're talking about how they set fire to the walls and stuff. And I guess if you build a big enough fire, like the limestone melts. If you build a big enough fire, like limestone melts and runs out of the walls and collapse and crack and stuff.
Nice. That's awesome.
Yeah. Well, siege warfare, I mean, you know, it's not very nice, but it's kind of cool with the trebuchets and the giant battering rams.
Did you guys watch that documentary? It was like a Kickstarter documentary that is now available on YouTube about the difference between real sword fighting and sword fighting in movies.
No.
And it's a bunch of...
Okay, Rich. We get the point.
It's not me.
You're not doing that? They're doing that?
They're doing that.
Oh, jeez.
That's from Anonymous.
All right.
And Anonymous says that Rich and Jack should backseat General Karen in FTL.
Oh, God. That would not work.
No. In general, Karen likes Rich at the moment, and we don't want him to backseat General too much. Or else that might end.
Connect to social network.
Oh, God.
No.
What are you doing?
What's going on?
What are you doing, game?
I don't know.
Game.
I'm saying okay, like, get out of here.
Just select a picture and say what.
Oh, I see. It's a little different on my tablet. It I guess you can the photo album, you can put like pictures from your tablet. Like I could put a picture of you in there and burn it. At the time I just had.
Is this something you've done?
Well, when I first got this game, I didn't have a lot of pictures on my tablet, so they were all like pictures of my dog and stuff, and I just like burnt pictures of him in effigy.
Oh, nice.
He didn't know.
Leftover Beefcake is donating some money to the Bring Back Fuckbot Fund, and I'm very, very sorry that I forgot to do that.
When did fuck ever leave?
Our fuckbot emoticon. I sacrificed our fuckbot emoticon to bring everyone the Science Mike emoticon.
Oh, okay.
And everyone agreed that that was a terrible, terrible decision, and I need to bring fuckbot back.
Okay. I thought they were arguing that you weren't saying fuck enough or something.
I usually try to keep my cursing not to a minimum, but, you know, I try to be reasonable with it. I think if you use it too much... Then,
it loses its magic.
It loses its power. Yeah.
The power of dirty words. Oh, the school bus! Zoom, zoom, zoom. Where does it go? Only the bus driver knows.
Did I say I love it when you get excited?
And the bank giving out pretend loans since the 80s.
Animus Prime, I get to make decisions because I know how to make emoticons and Rich doesn't. So that's why I get to make decisions.
You know how many fucks I give about emoticons? You could count them on zero hands.
Oh,
she wants fireflies, so as soon as this timer runs out, I will send her some fireflies.
That's why Jack got to make the decision. Tim is staying because I loved seeing Tim's face. I think we decided to get rid of the can of beer. Because
I didn't even know we had a can of beer emoticon.
Right.
Until we use it, like the other day when we were talking about
which one to get rid of. Right.
Flaming spiders. I mean, what's worse than regular spiders than jumping flaming spiders?
Oh my god! Oh my god! That's horrifying.
Isn't it?
That's terrible. They're alive.
Well, they were.
So I will get on that tomorrow. I will have some free time, and I will get our fuckbot emoticon back.
Okay.
It's all gonna be great.
School bus.
Mario, I know you decided to get rid of Tim, but I didn't decide to get rid of Tim because look at that face. I love that face. He's my favorite.
Is that green thing the fuckbot?
No, the green thing is Hack Fraud. Do you see the guy's face?
Well, there's another robot here that Dungeon Master blasted post of. Yeah. That's not fuckbot.
Yeah. The guy with the red hood is the one that they want to get rid of, which is very reasonable and understandable. I just love looking at his face, and so I want to keep it for me. But the smoking Game Boy, a.k.a. the can of beer, will be getting...
You ready to watch the school bus burn?
There's a what?
School bus. See with the kids in it?
Oh, my God.
All right.
Burn it.
Ooh!
That was horrifying. You guys are terrible. I love it.
Tales from the Dark Side.
We need to do this again.
This is your dark side. This is your dark side.
Well, I do have my... You know, I'm actually a very nice person, but I have been known to... see how miserable I can make my Sims until they die.
You should watch her play
drown
the Sims.
People in Roller Coaster Tycoon. Yeah, it turns out that if you give them plenty of food, if you give them plenty of food, but you deny them sleep or the ability to be clean or anything, you can eventually make them miserable enough that they die out of sheer misery.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah. Also, in Roller Coaster Tycoon, you can drown people in the lake, which is always kind of fun. Or you can build roller coasters that are grossly unsafe. In Roller Coaster Tycoon 2, you could kill people with them. But and even if they were like dinghies, they would explode, which is odd. Like, what, are they filled with hydrogen? But...
I'm so excited. Yeah. Talking about murdering people but in an amusement park.
In the third one, and the fourth one should be coming out really soon, but the third one, it's all crash test dummies, but they still scream. So you can, like, build slides, and you build a giant slide. You build, like, 1,000 foot of landscaping, and then you put, like, 1,000 foot tall slide on top of it, and you have it, like, in kind of a shape where they launch off the end of it, and then you listen to them scream, "Oh, no!" And they fall, like, 1,000 feet, and then they bounce, like, 700 feet, and there's
You know what this says
dust.
To me? Is there are so many people worried about, like, violent video games like first-person shooters. Uh-huh. Like, that's ruining America. All I say now is, like, the people who enjoy the violence in first-person shooters are probably lazy. Because we're not as imaginative as Karen is with her violence.
Well, if I build this roller coaster at a steep enough angle, it will fly off and crash into the lake with the pond is.
She thinks of more interesting ways
swimming.
To murder people than us dummies who just, you know, point guns at people.
She's watching this bus burn at these people's screen, and she has the most sinister smile on her face that I have ever seen.
It's like my favorite part of the game. That and there's like an opera singer, and you like when you set her on fire, roses come out and stuff.
Let's see the opera singer.
Oh, well, I haven't gotten to her yet.
Okay. You need burn more things.
Well, I have to burn things in the right order, which means I'd have to like kind of pay attention to what I'm doing.
Burn things in the right order.
Right combinations.
Cinnamon, yes, we are looking into Hard West, which is a Wild West style XCOM clone.
Yes, we are definitely looking into that.
We are looking into playing that and seeing how we feel about it.
The bank is on fire.
I don't think that's how it goes.
We don't need no money. Let the mother hee-haw burn. Burn, mother hee-haw burn. That's the radio edit.
They really have hee-haw?
Yeah.
That's kind of funny.
It's like a donkey hee-haw.
Okay, nothing is funnier than Die Hard edited for television.
It was like Apple or something.
You ice cream cone head. I mean, it's that bad.
I got a paper heart. Well, of course we're going to set that on fire.
He's a purple-loving flapjack.
Oh, jeez.
Did you look into why the stream audio is fuzzy?
We're fuzzy?
We shouldn't be fuzzy. We did do a... That might be your speakers. The notification for the tips and subs are echoing because we can hear them too.
Oh, yeah.
And then so, like, we hear them, and then our microphones pick them up, which then sends them out on a slight delay. So that's why they're echoing. The audio should not be fuzzy. We do before every stream, a test recording where we record some of the game, we record some of us talking
some
into the microphone.
Some people are saying for me it's perfect. I'm not worried
about
it.
We sounded fine in the test
speakers.
Recording.
I'm sorry, but your speakers
it might be your speakers.
Are bad.
And, of course, we just can't calibrate for everyone's speakers.
It's an anomaly in the space-time continuum.
That's what it is. That's exactly
Great
what it is.
Scott.
Rich is traveling back in time to stop his past self.
From stopping 9/11.
From
I think if you set the pirate on fire and the bicycle on fire at the same time, that's one of the combos.
Oh, that's what it is. Yippee-ki-yay, Mr. Falcon.
Oh, Mr. Falcon.
Mr. Falcon.
Yeah, see, there's the bike pirate combo. Yippee-ki-yay. That should be confused with a butt pirate.
A bike pirate.
And, okay. Ooh, more mail.
Tiberius Kirk, I'm sorry. It worked for us. Then that's all we can test for, and I'm very, very sorry that it's not working for you and other people, but there's only so much we can do to test our audio, and we cannot make it perfect for everyone, and I'm very, very sorry.
And it sounds like it's perfect for some people, which would make it even harder, because exactly. We could potentially go in another room and stream it on the Chromebook, and it might be just fine.
Maybe the problem is Twitch.
The problem could be Twitch. The problem could be internet connections. It could be a multitude of reasons, and unfortunately, there's no way for us to compensate. And I do.
It could be demonic possession. Really,
it's like demonic possession is most likely. Twitch is second likely. Our fault is like fifth likely, because it's definitely not our fault. We know exactly what we're doing all the time.
Okay, I think someone else's combo is probably like the credit card and the bank. That's got to be one of them. I don't know.
The credit card and the bank. Yeah, that seems like a good combo.
Yeah. I mean, if you want to play it, I mean, it's not usually a game that you sit there and play through. It's probably not that exciting to sit there and watch, but it's got its moments.
The plan is for you to have fun burning things until you're done having fun burning things. Yeah. And then we'll switch to something
until
else.
Burning things loses its luster.
Burning things never loses its luster. Can we talk about The Hunger Games?
The movie.
You can.
Which
I won't know anything about it, but that's fine.
Karen, have you seen the last one?
I have not.
Have you read the books?
I have.
I assumed you have, because I know you are an avid reader.
Yeah, I did read the books. I have not. Actually, I've read 2.5 books.
Okay.
I checked out the third one like on Kindle, and then I wanted to read something else, so I put it back. I never read the end of the third one, but I was waiting when they released the first. The movie version of the first book, and then the movie version of the second book, and then they released the movie version of the third book as two different movies.
That's right, because they like money.
Yeah, so I wanted to wait until they were both out.
Ah, okay.
And I just haven't gotten around to seeing them since.
Bill LaHacka, we cannot talk about Jessica Jones because there's just too many spoilers.
Yeah, it's too early. Even if all of us had seen all the episodes, it'd be way too early to get into it, because
I will say this much. I've seen the first episode. So far, I like the comics better.
Okay.
What did we want to talk about The Hunger Games? Oh, my God! The Hunger Games was extraordinarily violent in the book. They did tone it down a bit for the movie.
Gobbledygooks wants us to know in his tip, someday you guys should try DC Universe Online. It's for the PS4 and it's free, you fucks! Is that like a WoW with DC heroes?
I think so.
Everybody be Superman, you win.
Well, Superman versus Superman versus Superman versus Superman.
Charles Xavier could take Superman.
Well, of course.
How about Galactus?
Well, oh, no. You know what?
Well, Galactus is
Superman. Marvel. Superman sometime is not in the DC universe, he is not affected by psychics.
Since when? Really?
As far as I know. Right. You know what Superman is weak against? Mm. Magic.
Yeah, Doctor Strange, then.
Doctor Strange could take
on
Superman.
Would beat the shit out of Superman.
Just utterly murder him.
And here's the thing. Is Superman, quote, weak to magic? Or is it just that he doesn't have any special protections against it? He's just as weak against magic as everyone else is.
Maybe that's it.
Like a spell that would turn Superman into a frog would also turn somebody else into a frog, but it wouldn't turn Superman into more of a frog, would it?
Okay.
Is that the deal with magic and Superman?
He's not invulnerable to magic like he's invulnerable to everything else.
Okay, that's always been my assumption. I don't know if that's true.
Yeah. He-Man could beat up Superman?
Oh, He-Man sucks.
He-Man.
Cartoon He-Man. He's a schmuck.
Oh, okay.
I thought He-Man's main purpose was like softcore gay porn.
Yes, Cartoon He-Man's main purpose is softcore porn.
What are you talking about? Don't you like my loincloth and leather chest straps?
Hold on, let me transform into my everyday pink outfit.
I'm going to ride this tiger. I'm going to ride the tiger.
I have
oh,
a very
God.
Tidy haircut.
I would like to know what the breakdown is for purchases that were buyer for children and purchases that were buyer for adult men who love men.
Okay. I'm sorry. Can we just go back to in Rich's head, gay pornography is all about tidy haircuts. I have a very tidy haircut. Ooh, that's scandalous. Ooh.
Well, unless you're talking about, like, the bears, then they're like, you know, wolfman kind of thing.
Well, you know, but I'm sure their beards are well trimmed.
Yeah, probably. Their chest hair is carefully manicured and shaved into a heart.
We've offended so many people.
If anyone is offended by tidy haircuts, they can go fuck themselves.
Why does our viewership keep going down?
Springtime combo. Let's see. That probably has to do with flowers. And maybe bugs?
Flowers and bugs. Ooh, yeah. That's good.
What else would be springy?
Corn?
Sure. Farmer Jack. Because there's no time that isn't the right time to set another school bus on fire. I love the way it just takes off and all the kids are yelling. That and the opera singer that comes up later who sings and burns and roses fall out of the sky. She's fun too. And the cat that explodes into a pile of poop.
That's the thing, Bill LaHecka. We talked about this when we were discussing Mr. Max Landis the other day, and some people brought up his haircut, which they find to be offensive in some way, ridiculous.
You're 11, and what is this?
Like He-Man's very tidy haircut, I don't care. If you have hair, you can do whatever you want with it. That's your choice. I don't get the choice.
Sure you do. You can wear a crazy-ass rainbow wig.
A wig, sure, but it's not my hair. I don't have a choice with what I can do with my hair anymore. That has been taken away from me.
I'm sorry. So,
I'm losing that privilege.
It's a battle that you can't win, Rich. You have to accept the inevitability.
Well, my options are limited right now, though, because I'm on screen with you all the time.
Yeah.
So I cannot shave my head.
You cannot. No, we cannot have two bald men.
Not that I wouldn't look terrible with a bald head anyway.
Uh-huh.
I would look like Charlie Brown.
Well, then you just got to roll with it and draw a little squiggle on your forehead. Wear a lot of yellow.
Oh, my God.
Here's the thing, Rich. I think you will be able to handily pull off the George Costanza.
No!
I think so.
That is the worst look.
I think it's going to look great on you.
No.
I do.
No. I refuse. I you know what? Fuck it. I'll wear a goddamn rug before that happens.
And the popcorn.
I'm not pulling the George Costanza look.
I think it would look good on you.
Fuck you. You do it. You do it. It's so great.
It doesn't work for me. It just doesn't work for me.
I still got something on top. Not as much as I'd like.
If I grew my hair out, you have more than I would have right now.
Mm-hmm.
I just have the crown, and it doesn't look good when I grow it out. Note to self: open trendy hat shop and hap shop. Open trendy hat shop and profit. Yeah, you could do that.
Buy a pet rat and train him to sit on your head.
Ooh. Wear a samurai cop wig. That's ooh. I like that, Rich. Go full Hulk Hogan and only wear bandanas. That'll be your thing.
No.
No, because
that'll be your shtick.
Hogan doesn't just wear bandanas. His shtick is that he's got that stringy blonde hair hanging out of the bottom.
Exactly.
Just like my brother had for a while. My brother was like a metalhead kid. And he, you know, went bald young. And for years, he had like this curtain of shoulder length hair and nothing on the top. You don't want that
one. Oh, yeah.
And then he decided to, you know, cut it short and he looks nice.
Yeah, like the Captain Picard works. Like that's a look that works where you keep a little bit of hair on the sides. You can see, like, if you look back to the very first episode of Best of the Worst that I'm on, is when I had is when I was rocking the Costanza. I had slightly longer crown ring around, and it looks terrible. I hate it. I hate looking at it.
But you should totally do that, Rich.
Huh?
But you should totally do that.
It'll
Rich.
Work for you.
No, it won't.
I think it would.
Well, if it
you know why? You have a wider head than I do.
Well, you know, I mean, there's always the option of like, oh, I don't like it. Let's shave all of it.
That's the thing.
But then I'm like
we get two guys on camera with a completely bald head.
You know,
you can't do that. You can't do that. It doesn't work.
Is there some kind of law that
it would destroy the space-time continuum?
It would.
You would look at that. You would turn on like one of our videos, and it would just be weird. It's like, what are they going for? Like a weird spaceman thing? What is that?
By the way, that's what we would do.
Just put on silver outfits.
Put on silver outfits.
Silver plastic outfits.
We would change the sets.
Put some tinfoil on your hair.
It would be called Previously Recorded from the Future.
No, just in space.
That's it. Previously Recorded in Space.
Get some of those wigs like the judges in England wear.
Ooh. That's exactly what we would do if it ever came to that. And it might. We don't know.
I'm trying to get to figure out what the generations combo is. I've burned every picture together. I think you can burn three things at a time and it still works.
How many things can you burn at once?
As many as you have slots in your thing to buy at once. So, like, I think, like, it starts out with, like, three or four. Eventually, you can burn, like, six things at a time.
Oh, sure, sure.
Also, it's limited to some extent what you can afford to buy.
Oh, okay.
But it's, you know, when you burn stuff, you get money. It costs money to burn stuff, but you get money when you burn stuff, so.
Ah, okay.
You come out ahead. All right. I don't think
we'll wear V-necks. So we'll find, like, silver suits with V-necks. So it shows, like, a subtle amount of chest hair. Not, like, too much to make it weird, but just a little bit, like a puff.
And should we also buy a bunch of He-Man action figures?
Silver spacesuits with V-necks, He-Man action figures, and shaved heads. But you know what? We'd have to go full on commit to the bit and also shave our eyebrows. Shave our face, head, and eyebrows.
This sounds like a terrible idea.
This sounds like a great idea. That's what I'm saying. This sounds like a great idea. That's exactly what's going to happen. I guess we could just paint our head, too.
Yeah, but then people have, like, weird rumors that you've got some kind of medical condition that you guys are all missing your eyebrows. Something in the water.
Powder reviews games.
Leukemia gamers.
Oh, yeah.
It'll be a whole shtick.
Ooh, I like that. Bill LaHecka says, for an April Fool's pre-rec episode, Rich will shave his head and Jack will have hair.
What if I shaved it and it didn't grow back?
Oh, my God.
I couldn't do that.
Quite a possibility, Rich. It's quite a possibility.
Gaming with chemo.
Oh. And now listen to the children scream.
Yeah, I'm trying to remember what the generations combo is or figure it out. Maybe you only have to burn two things together.
Oh, tired and sad. I'm so glad that you watched Double Down.
I need a springtime combo and a generations combo.
After,
and I don't feel like looking online and cheating.
Don't cheat. Just experiment. After our last stream, I got many tweets and many comments of people who are fully now converted to the Church of Breen.
Karen has no idea what we're talking about.
Well, that's okay.
Church
you know
of
what?
Brain or Breen?
Breen. Rich, it is your responsibility as a Breenolite to spread the good word of our Lord and Savior. Though that Breen, man, that who can do no wrong, Breen. Breezes loves you and is perfect in every way.
I don't know if I can talk to you because last time we talked about this, if you recall, there was a schism in the church.
A schism?
Yeah.
I don't remember a schism.
I believed in the duology of the Breen. You were a single-minded Breen.
Oh, that's right. You believe in multiple Breens.
Yeah. Well, the two faces, the two sides of the Breen.
Right. And there is no two sides. It's all one Breen.
The holy duology.
And as we've discussed last time, the Breen is powerful enough where he is only one Breen. So you're right. I'm a unibreenitarian.
The Breen can be as many Breens as he wants to be. All right, there is a man, Karen.
Is there something in the water up here in Wisconsin?
Yes.
Can you hand me those sour mints? I need to fortify myself for whatever crazy-ass stuff you're going to spout right now.
There is a man who made a movie.
Okay.
And in the movie,
that he made, that he produced and wrote.
And directed and starred.
And directed and stars in. He is the world's best computer hacker, secret agent, cool guy.
Jet fighter pilot.
Jet fighter pilot. He does everything better than everybody.
And he tells you that he does everything better than everybody.
And everybody around him tends to agree that he is the best.
At everything.
Whatever it is.
Okay.
And it's one of the most Double Down is one of the most amazing movies I've ever seen.
Karen would hate Double Down.
Well, you know, it takes a special kind to enjoy bad movies in general. But,
yeah.
So I don't. You're right. I'm more of an orthodox Breenian.
I understand that people like bad movies for their badness, and occasionally I can like bad movies for their badness, but mostly I'd just rather watch a good movie. Yeah.
So
you know what that is? Understandable.
Karen hates bad movies.
Uh-huh.
She also hates, oh my God. Okay. I know.
Well, they're stupid.
You know what that makes her rich? The counterbalance. and that's really important.
Well, I mean, there are some movies that are generally considered kind of cheesier that I like. I'm a big fan of Attack of the Killer Tomatoes.
Yeah. Skeletal Snoogles is donating to the Church of Breezes. Praise!
Oh my God!
Praise be to the one true Breezes. And Fisted by Dope Smoke is tipping us to say please
fisted
play a different
by what?
Game. Dope Smoke.
Okay.
Fisted by Dope Smoke would like to tip us to say please play a different game.
Somebody blowing smoke up their ass?
Rich, don't do it. My wife almost divorced me for watching Double Down.
Isn't that the sandwich that they had at Kentucky Fried
yes,
Chicken?
Yes, it is.
That is the sandwich. Oh, you know what? That just means you need to know your wife better. Like, I explained the plot of Double Down to my wife the next day. And was laughing so hard while I was remembering the movie. But I would never make her watch it. She's not into bad movies.
So, Karen, I know we've talked about The Martian, like, the book with you, like, two of the times you've been on the show.
Yeah.
The Martian book.
But you did see the movie.
I did see the movie.
Well, what did you think of the movie?
I thought it was a very good adaptation of the book. It was top-notch. I mean, yeah, there were some things that they had to sacrifice. There was less focus on the interpersonal dynamics between the NASA people. There were a couple of things from the I don't want to be spoiling anything.
Yeah, don't spoil it.
There were a couple of things from the movie or book that figured fairly prominently that were left out. But and you know, a few little things that they changed, like he write stuff in marker instead of Morse coding it in rocks, which, you know, things that were just more practical to have on screen.
Mm-hmm.
One of the big things that weirded me out, but I'm probably the only person in the world who cares about this, the suits. They look nice, but why would you have a suit that has fluorescent orange details on Mars? This sort of thing makes sense in general, having things be hot orange because it's an attention-getting color that, you know, that contrast with things. But if you want to be visible on Mars, fluorescent orange isn't the color you want.
But
you
when
want, like, blue or green.
But when you're making a movie, it makes for a very nice color palette.
You know what? The poster is very exciting. Seeing him in that suit on the poster, not on Mars.
You're on Mars. You got to wear rust tones.
Karen, people are saying a flowers plus a clock.
Flowers plus clock. Okay.
Flowers
plus springtime.
Springtime.
I was just kind of, you know, I gave up and I was just methodically doing one at a time. But flowers plus clock. Yeah, that does
sense.
Sound right.
That makes
Thank
way
you.
More sense. Thank you, chat.
Pretty soon we're going to be able to unlock the second catalog and burn more in different things.
Double Down is on YouTube? Oh, my God. It's probably an illegal copy, so I cannot really endorse it, but I don't think there is a legal way to view Double Down at the moment.
Just watch it on YouTube.
I know. I officially cannot endorse it, but you know, but you should see it. Wink. You can't see me winking right now. I'm really sorry.
I can't fucking control what you do. Wink. It's there. I can't make it not there.
Oh, pardon me. Sorry about that, everybody.
It's okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Did I unlock the combo?
I don't know.
I did.
Yay!
So does anybody want to tell me what the Generations combo is so we can move on to catalog
so
number two and burn different stuff?
So the, I see two family pictures. Have you burnt those?
Yeah, I tried burning the two family pictures together.
Is it like a...
It's two. It's definitely two. I'm trying the
Raven Bauman says spider eggs and portrait.
Okay.
I don't...
Yep, if you didn't come with someone else, Joe Kitty 001 says spider eggs and family picture two.
Yeah, I mean, there's, you know...
What's the name of the thing? Generations?
Yeah. See, I mean, I played through this whole game. I think there was, like, one I couldn't figure out at all, and I went online and looked it up. But for the most part, I mean, I did methodically play through this game, but I did it, you know, a few minutes here and there over a period of weeks. Just screwing around with a little here and there.
Ow. So it doesn't matter if you have a third item in there? It's not going to freak out?
I don't think it does.
Cat picture.
But let's see. Oops, I don't think I don't know if I burned those together enough. I might have to redo it. Because my spiders. Look at all the spiders! They're on fire and they're
spider
jumping.
Eggs and the
I mean, what could be more horrifying than jumping spiders on fire?
After being born. You get born into a world of fire.
Don't make me feel sorry for them. It's just a game. I'm the one who felt sorry. When I was little, my mom got me, like, this chocolate-covered popsicle thing with eyes, and I, like, ate them, and then I, like, felt completely brokenhearted, and she had to put Google Eyes on it. Don't tap into that side of my neuroticism, okay? I'm focusing on the, ew, spiders are icky, look, they're on fire. What could be more horrifying than burning spiders? Not baby spiders suffer.
What the gobbledygooks...
Nope.
Would like us to read from the Book of Breen.
So what was it? Spider eggs
so
and
So saith the Breen.
Spider eggs and there's a family picture.
Fateful Findings is not repped by Pan Entertainment for theatrical screening. If you know of an FF screening, let me know. It's illegal. So saith Breen.
Oh dear.
Oh dear.
I love Breen. I love Breen. I love him too, but that I think that religion joke, it's running out of legs.
Running out of steam.
Running out of steam.
Running out of brain steam.
I think you need to have more King James English thrown in there.
Right.
You know, verily I say unto thee.
Listen.
Oh, ye of little faith.
We run jokes well into the ground here. That's kind of the thing. Yay!
No, I think I get my other catalog. And yes, more flaming dead spiders, dying spiders, whatever. Spiders built, burnt, you know. On the other hand, you know, while they're born into a world of pain, they don't suffer for long. They'll never need therapy or antidepressants or whatever spiders have. Okay, so did I get my other catalog? Oh, wait, did I already have a second catalog? I don't even know. But here's the new catalog. Definitely buy the new catalog. Gotta buy the new catalog. Want to set a raccoon on fire? Raccoon plushie. It should be... It
just
should,
a plushie. Oh.
It should say trash panda. Well, but it does say...
Panda?
Yeah, you never heard that? There's like online they have like... People have like taken pictures on some Reddit or whatever.
Uh-huh.
And they take pictures of animals and they give them different names.
Okay.
Like the snakes say nope noodles and the rays say majestic sea flap flap, but the raccoons say trash panda, which is like the perfect name for a raccoon.
A raccoon is like a trash panda. I love it. I officially love it.
Yeah.
I wholeheartedly endorse renaming raccoons to be trash pandas.
Oh, the space heater is great. This is like a really dangerous space heater that sets stuff on fire for you.
Well, why would you want something to set something on fire for you?
Because you just set it down and then it, like, sets other shit on fire. Which is kind of fun.
It sounds like the game is, like, slowly encouraging you not to play the game. What is that?
Oh, just watch.
Is that a muskrat eating a musket?
It's a squirrel whistle. Look, see. Okay, so now you've got your space heater. You just set it there.
Uh-huh.
And then it, like, overheats and sets all their shit on fire. There goes the rabid trash panda.
This is horrifying.
The whole game is horrifying.
What?
I'm usually a nice person.
There is a dark side.
How's that going? You know the thing. Oh, like by heart.
You want the beginning credits or the closing credits? Man lives in the sunlit world of what he believes to be reality.
What is happening?
But there is, unseen by most,
what is happening?
An underworld, a place that is just as real, but not as brightly lit. A dark side.
What is it? What is this?
The dark side is always there, waiting for us to enter. Waiting to enter us. Until next time, try to enjoy the... You never seen that show? It's great.
Jack's a baby. He's a baby. He's a few years younger than us.
Yeah.
And just enough.
And we were pretty young when that came out.
Like Jack knows what a Power Ranger is?
Yeah.
We missed
no, that one. I have a Power Rangers shirt. You were like, you have a Power Rangers shirt? And I was like, yeah, it came in a loot crate. All I know is that it's...
Somebody said it was Twilight Zone with boobs. Boobs.
Ooh.
Tales from the Dark Side.
It was a
I'm interested in this now.
It was a very cheesy, kind of lame... Like one guy, he was like dead and he didn't want to admit it. And then somebody put pepper on it in his handkerchief and he sneezed off his nose and then he believed he was dead. It was just really cheesy, kind of horror themed weekly evening TV show. But the credits are just this shot of the woods and then everything like turns black and white and the announcers are going, Man lives in the sunlit world of what. It's got great credits, and that's mostly all it has going for it.
Was Tales from the Dark Side the one that had the episode with the diet, the weight loss glasses? And the lady put the weight loss glasses on, and when she put the glasses on, her food had faces and could talk to her. And they were begging her not to eat them. It was like an apple.
It might have been.
Please don't eat us!
There was another show
and
that
she
was
eventually
just bad around that era. That
she eventually starves to death because she can't bring herself to eat food anymore.
I love it.
It might have been. There was another show that was on around that era that was just as bad, and I can't think of the name of it.
I love it.
Please don't eat me.
Yeah, it was adorable little fruits.
I don't think it was that. I think it was more like, oh my god, you're not going to eat me! Please! I don't want to die!
Yeah, but the fruits themselves, they looked adorable. They had cute little eyes, cute little mouths.
Okay, so it was the Twilight Zone with more boobs and Tales from the Crypt with less boobs. So somewhere in between Twilight Zone and Tales from the Crypt.
Maybe.
As far as boob level is concerned. I'm okay with this.
Yeah, that was on network TV. I don't think there were many boobs in Tales from the Dark Side.
Yeah.
Oh, so maybe like cleavage?
Maybe.
Listen, the amount of boobs in a TV show is very important to me.
It was like the Twilight Zone as a horror done by people with the humor sensibilities of like Quantum Leap or something. I don't even know. It was just, it's kind of silly, kind of lighthearted, kind of cheesy.
Nice.
Not the best written necessarily, but the credits were great. I think everybody can pretty much agree that the credits were nice. Twilight Zone had really good credits, too, and so did, what was it?
Twilight Zone holds up to this fucking day.
Yeah.
Yeah, oh, the writing and the... Well, because, I mean, like, I've talked about this before. I think that really well-written things work as plays. I think, to me, that's, like, the deciding factor with a lot of these things. Is it well-written? Would it work on stage?
Hmm.
Well, I mean, if something works on stage, anything that works on stage had to be well-written.
Yeah.
I don't necessarily know that something has to work on stage to be well written, but if something's going to work on stage, it probably has to be.
Possibly. You know, like, you're not taking into account things like excellent cinematography.
Right.
Know. Okay.
But, you know, there are movies with very little dialogue that just, you know, has excellent camera work that would
Fair
obviously
enough.
Never work on
Mad like. Max Fury Road would not work on stage. I would love to see them try.
Oh my god, yes.
56 dead at Mad Max Fury Road premiere. 56 dead.
Oh no. No, but I'm thinking like Rich and I are both. Jack, have you ever seen Flight of the Phoenix?
Flight of the Phoenix?
I've seen the original, yeah.
The original.
With you.
Yeah. The original would work perfectly well. You don't know about Flight of the Phoenix, Jack.
Flight of the Phoenix.
It's an old Jimmy Stewart movie that they remade recently with Dennis Quaid.
Which was a bad idea.
I don't know, 7 years ago?
No. Yeah. No, I don't know.
They decided it needs more explosions and more battles and more...
It needed to end in a terrorist battle or something.
Something.
Was that?
What is it? Describe Flight of the Phoenix.
The whole gist of the movie is
well, there was people, a... Well, you were talking about me, too.
Well, these people, yeah. These people have crashed in the Gobi Desert or somewhere. They've crashed in the desert, and this one guy says... is a twist of exactly what he does for a living, but he says, we can take the parts of what's left of our plane and salvage it and turn it into a different kind of plane.
And he's a very mean-spirited German guy.
Well, he's cold and he's methodical. Like, he's saying, well, this plane will hold, like, five people. And they're like, well, what about such and such? And they're like, well, you said he would only live 3 days, and this is going to take five, so we don't have to worry about him because he's going to be dead, you know?
So
him and Jimmy Stewart get into it. This guy is... This movie was written, you know, probably, 20 years after the Second World War or something. So he's like your stereotypical Nazi character. The guy, Hardy Krueger, who played the actor from it, he actually was a Nazi film actor during the Second World War and the lead up to that in Germany.
That's slander.
No, I mean, he really was.
He was
involved, actually, it's historically accurate. I have no idea what his personal beliefs were, you know, whether he did that by choice or coercion, but he actually did star in some Nazi propaganda films during the war.
Oh, wow. Okay.
But anyway, so is it a spoiler if I tell what happened, what the big twist is?
At this point, no.
If you plan on
tracking down this old 50-year-old movie that is really good, put your fingers in your ears for the next 30 seconds.
Yeah. So the twist is that this guy is a model airplane designer.
Okay.
And when the Jimmy Stewart character and these other people find out, they're like, well, you know, this is crazy. Of course, you know, there's no way we're all going to die. There's no way this is going to work. You just design toys, and he doesn't get it, you know. And he's like, well, it's all the same principles, and he's right, it is. And I think there's a little bit of battle with some people who show up, some kind of raiders in the desert. But they remade the movie with all kinds of CGI and giant battle scenes and terrorists and bad dialogue and no interaction. The original one, it's all about the dialogue and the concepts, and it would work on a stage just fine.
But what makes the movie work, though, is that the only person who can possibly save their lives is a tremendous asshole.
Yes. A tremendous asshole, possibly a Nazi, and he's a model arrogant model aircraft designer.
I like that. I like that idea.
It's a wonderful movie.
He goes on strike once because he doesn't think people are working hard enough, so he stops telling them how to make the plane.
Yeah.
I like the idea of, like, an effective dickhead.
Yeah.
Like, not just effective at being a dickhead, but, like, someone who gets stuff done who is also a dickhead. Someone in which you are forced to put up with.
Yeah.
Yeah, I like that.
Look, there's people heads coming out of it. Did you see that?
The teddy bear is really disturbing.
Was that the teddy bear? Which one did the people heads come shooting out of?
The bottle of whatever that is.
Bottle of
best friend's supplement pills.
All right, we'll burn these one at a time. Yeah, the teddy bear and the steam engine. We'll do one at a time. Studies show that oil spills help baby animals float.
Chernobyl Kinsman, I agree with you. Effective asshole works great in Army of Darkness.
Ash, well, we watched last night. We watched that.
I made Karen watch Ash versus Evil Dead.
Oh yeah, was there a new one this Saturday? I didn't.
I don't know. Okay, I'm assuming.
I'm not caught up. If there was a new one this Saturday,
We watched the first one anyway.
Oh well, that's
you're not a huge fan. What did you think of the first episode?
I thought it was kind of fun. I mean, it was silly in a good way.
Yes,
it was deeply silly.
Deeply silly. Ooh, House is another good example, or any Sherlock Holmes, you know, like, just an effective...
Oh, yeah, character. Sherlock Holmes was like just kind of some jerkwad heroin addict, but he was brilliant.
But he was brilliant, right, so everyone had to put up with him being a huge dickhead.
Was Sherlock so Holmes was House, a huge dickhead, though? House was a huge dickhead.
Well, I believe, like, he was written to be a huge dickhead, but relativity... Like,
our memory is...
Oh, well, no, but our concept of what a dickhead is now and what a dickhead was back then is slightly different.
Okay.
And so, like, House if you look at House is a perfect like remake of Sherlock Holmes.
Yeah.
Well, that's exactly what Sherlock Holmes would be nowadays.
Well, I've heard that they gave him the name House as an homage to Holmes.
Oh, yeah. Sure. Yeah. I believe that. So I believe that is the proper successor to Sherlock Holmes in modern day.
What's his friend's name on the show? Was he the cancer doctor? I can't remember. Wilson. Yeah. Watson Wilson's Wilson. Another W
yeah.
name.
Oh, right. Sure. Yeah.
Elementary, my dear Wilson.
House is a drug addict, too? Yeah, that makes sense.
An opiate addict, in fact. Both of them. Specifically. Although I think it's possible Sherlock was doing a certain amount of cocaine, too, if memory serves.
I don't know if Han Solo would quite fit in. You know, like, Han Solo, you know, is the thief with the heart of gold.
Yeah, that's a different thing.
That's a
Han shot
and
first.
It's kind of like Shades of Grey, but, like, it's subtly different where he's not the biggest dickhead. He's just kind of a prick.
He's just kind of cocky.
Yeah. Yeah, just kind of cocky.
A little selfish.
He doesn't tell people to fuck off. Weren't they going to give House like a smarter brother like Sherlock Holmes had to at some point?
Oh, sure. Like Mycroft,
I believe.
Minecraft? Like Minecraft?
I don't think there's an end in there. I think it's just Mycroft.
Okay, who is House's Moriarty?
The guy who shot him in that one episode was, I think, credited as Moriarty.
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
It wasn't like a major character, but he did get shot once. And I think in the credits, just the random person who shot him is credited as Moriarty.
Was it like season 3 or 4 where he like had just a cop hounding him
for his drugs?
Or was that season 2? Or
yeah.
Season 2, I think.
Like there was a season long nemesis.
Yeah.
Yeah, the cop was kind of a jag-off.
And like, but the cop was also like very methodical, very like.
Yeah.
Very clever, like House was, just not as clever. So that could be the Moriarty.
Yeah, and arguably right about a lot of things.
House's Moriarty is lupus. Says Tiberius Kirk.
That's
it's
great.
Not lupus.
It's, but it's not
never lupus.
Lupus. You know, I got as a gift once the entire collected works of Sherlock Holmes. And I would I would really like to read them, but I just have never cared enough to get around to it. It's constantly on my list where it's like, I would love to read Sherlock Holmes.
Jack, I have the answer for you.
Yeah?
Audiobooks.
Audiobooks.
Yeah. I find, you know, well, I mean, you may or may not have downtime where you're at work or driving or whatever, where you where you have to do things with your hands, but you don't necessarily have to use your mind a lot.
Sure.
And I listened to the whole one book that I had always meant to get into, but it just never could seem to get into it, was Tale of Two Cities. And I listened to the entire thing on audiobook, and it was great. Mm. And it took about 20 hours, but, you know, you listen to it like 20 minutes.
You know,
here,
I suppose if you have the right narrator, right?
Well, anything, yeah, that matters.
Anything can be wonderful and exciting.
Yeah. And I'm sure with the Sherlock Holmes books, you could probably, and you can listen to the samples and whatnot before you purchase, but you could probably, for each one of those books, you know, choose from 5 different narrators.
Right. Oh, sure. What we need is, now I can't remember. We need Hugh Laurie reading Sherlock Holmes. He has Hugh Laurie has a wonderful, deep British accent.
Okay, so you would want it in his native accent,
of
him to put on a historically accurate something that Americans would know the difference.
And now that I say Hugh Laurie, I want Stephen Fry to read it to me because he has like his voice is a little deeper, a little more soothing. Just
we were just listening to him last night. He was
reading to me,
Stephen. The Go the Fuck to Sleep.
Oh, sure. Samuel L. Jackson.
Right. Well,
there's a sequel.
There's a sequel called, like, Why the Fuck Won't You Eat or something. And it's it's about where they're trying to get the child to eat. And that one is read by Stephen Fry.
Oh,
he does
that's
an
great.
Excellent job. Really
He's
excellent.
Great.
He is.
Stephen Fry is great. Everybody's great.
Ooh, someone in the chat wants Patrick Stewart to do Sherlock Holmes.
Oh, I would like that. No, but he's done a lot of Shakespearean stuff. So not only is he English, but he can probably do multiple accents. And
yeah. Vin Diesel reading Sherlock Holmes.
Vin Diesel.
I would love that. I would love it.
Elementary, my dear Watson.
That was a really good Vin Diesel impression.
He goes on deep and dumb.
Not that he's probably dumb in real life.
No, actually, he's quite smart in real life.
Yeah, okay. So. But I mean, it's his on-screen persona.
Yeah.
Meathead.
Oh, yeah.
Meathead.
Yeah. I believe he's one of those that will always come up on the, like,
15 actors you didn't know were really smart
lists. Those awful, awful lists.
Winnie Cooper is like a doctor now.
Yes, I'm agreeing with the chat. A Fry reading Hitchhiker's Guide would be great. Actually, it sounds like he might have.
Oh, Jesus,
oh,
yes.
Oh, I need to look up for... You need to look out for that. I need to find that.
I used to, like, I used to have a lot more, like, audio free time where I got into, like, podcasts and audiobooks a lot. Unfortunately, most of my editing now, I have to listen, you know, I have to listen to Rich and I talk is the worst kind of editing because I have to listen to us. And I can't listen to audiobooks.
Why won't the
needle
burn?
That was pretty insensitive, like Bill Cosby, you know, doing the audio version of the Accused. I don't think that was in very good taste.
You don't think I?
No.
You know, the thing is, he did it really recently. Like, it wasn't even something he did way back.
Weeks ago.
Like, what? Like, who even read that one anymore? Like, why bring it up, Bill Cosby? Ugh.
Oh, the opera singer. I love her. She's fun. They have the crappy cat? No, he's not this one yet.
Why are the lists Christopher Walken voice? I don't know. It was just the voice that came up in my head. There are Sherlock video games?
Well, probably.
Oh, I suppose.
Well, if there's Nancy Drew...
There's Nancy Drew video games?
There sure are.
Shit, yeah, we're going to play the fuck out of some Nancy Drew.
I think they're probably, you know, targeted at 11-year-old girls, and they're, like, kind of point-and-clicky or something. I haven't actually played any.
That sounds right up my alley. I don't know what you're talking
Did you
about.
Ever read any of the Nancy Drew books?
None.
They're actually... I enjoyed them when I was a kid. I mean, I think adults could enjoy them, too. They're certainly more complicated as mysteries than the Encyclopedia Brown, which, you know, going back and reading them now, it's like, so obvious.
Oh, sure.
But it maybe isn't when you're 9. It wasn't obvious to me when I was 9. Look at the watcher.
Oh, that's so sad. It's tragic.
Yeah.
It's tragic. There are 20 Nancy Drew video games? Holy crap.
And all the roses fall out of the sky.
Aw.
Yeah.
Now I feel bad. So how's burning things going? How's this working out for you?
Oh, pretty good. I mean, if you want to do something else game-wise, I'm fine with that. I'm just kind of...
Oh, sure. And, you know, I was just... I'm just hitting the point where I'm ready to go to bed.
Okay.
And so I'm gonna leave.
All right. Thank you for stopping by.
No. Oh, hey. Thank you for having me. Bye. Like, I just felt the need to blow my nose again, and thinking of blowing my nose again made me really sleepy.
All right. So all right.
That's what I'm going to do. So you guys figure it out. Don't forget when you hear the oh my god to check your alerter to see what they say. But hey, bye everybody. Thanks for
bye Jack. For feel better out. Soon.
And having a super fun time.
You sure you don't want to take the rest of these sour mints with you? You can have them.
I don't know.
They're
you.
Like, can we do product placements? Excitement.
Roundy's brand sour
Excitement
flavored mints.
Freshened your mouth. Available at Aldi's.
If you're big on a product brand and you wanna hawk them for free.
I think Aldi's brand excitements are
casual
as good
horse
as the other
friend.
Ones,
casual
but cheaper.
Horse. No, I'm just leaving because I'm sick and... I don't want, like, I'm going to go home and go to bed. Like, don't worry.
The stream's not ending. Jack
the stream
is
just
not
ending.
Off.
And don't worry. Jack I'm not going ending. Home to spend time with my family or any other bullshit reason like that. I'm going to go to sleep. It's going to be great. Goodbye.
Bye, Jack.
Oh, God. I got to blow my nose. Oh, boogers are coming.
If I get sick, I'm blaming you.
You should.
Oh my god! All right, so we're shutting this down.
The streamer.
This game.
Yeah.
All right. Give me a second here. I gotta read that comment.
I remember we only read comments for $2 or over.
Give me the keyboard. Okay. Keyboard. I need my keyboard.
Yeah, bundle up. This is gonna be. Stay warm out there, folks. Keep it warm.
Is it a samurai?
What is temperature
reference?
Out there? It's kind of cold.
It's very cold.
When I parked, I like, you know, the lots sloped in places, so it was like, well, okay. I will make sure that I park in a way where I am facing downhill in case I can't get traction.
Ooh, that's good.
Well,
idea.
I put the car in park and shut the car off, and the car continued to skid along for about 5 feet. It was in park. The wheels are locked, and it's just sliding down through the parking lot.
Goodbye.
Bye.
But hey, the doggy daycare is cold, so.
Doggy daycare?
Yeah.
What about the doggy daycare?
Doggy daycare next door is cold.
Mm. Bye bye. Bye.
So the little critters are inside. So there's that.
You wanna do bookworm? Bookworm sound good?
Yeah.
Yeah, a little bookworm. We're gonna spell some fucking words. As soon as I can find them.
F-U-C-K-I-N-G. Oh, I'm sorry. S-O-M-E. F-U-C-K-I-N-G-W-O-R-D-S.
That's very good.
Cold star for Robot Girl. Now.
There we are.
We're not there, we're here.
Oh, we're not quite there. I gotta set it so everyone else can see it too.
Why wouldn't we do that?
So everyone else can see it too.
Can you hand me my tablet? Mm.